The purpose of an abandoned ship drill is to ensure that all passengers and crew on a ship are familiar with the procedures to be followed in the event of an emergency requiring the evacuation of the ship. Abandoned ship drills give the opportunity to gain experience in the use of the safety equipment in cooperation and makes the crew more familiar with the life-saving appliances on board and increases their confidence that the appliances will work and will be effective in an emergency. The abandoned ship drill is carried out at least once per month and covers various important topics, all of which we will explore in this video. The abandoned ship drill should be announced via the ship's public address system with an appropriate sound signal. All crew should proceed to the muster station. At the same time, the captain, along with the navigation officer on the bridge, will carry out the procedure of signaling distress to the nearest vessels and rescue coordination centers. Muster station is a designated location where all crew members gather in the event of emergency situations. Depending on the type of ship, the muster station can be on either the port or starboard side, or it may be located close to the lifeboat at the aft. Its specific location will be indicated in the muster list and ship's fire plan. Ensuring you know the muster station's position on your vessel is crucial for a swift response in case of an emergency. Grab your life jacket, immersion suit, then proceed directly to the muster station. According to the muster list duties, certain crew members are responsible for bringing additional important items such as water and provisions, SART and APIRB devices, pyrotechnics, documents, and any other necessary supplies. After the crew has gathered at the muster stations, the first responsibility for the safety officer is to ensure that everyone is counted for and that nobody is missing. We need to ensure the working condition of life jacket lights and whistles. All crew will be checked for their knowledge of duties and responsibilities as per the muster list. As part of the monthly abandoned ship drill, we are required by SOLAS to lower the lifeboat. Additionally, the complete lowering and maneuvering process is performed at least once every 3 months. As per SOLAS, all survival crafts required for abandonment on board the cargo vessel should be ready for launching within a period of 10 minutes from the time the abandoned ship signal is given. For passenger ships, this requirement is 30 minutes. SOLAS says that drills shall, as far as practicable, be conducted as if there were an actual emergency, but from other IMO documents they said that the time limit set out in SOLAS for ship abandonment should be considered as a secondary objective when conducting drills. As I mentioned before, the abandoned ship drill is designed for training purposes to improve the skills and teamwork of crew members. The crew's experience is an important factor in determining how fast a drill or certain drill elements should be carried out. During the lifeboat lowering, it's not necessary for all crew members to be inside for safety reasons. However, for lifeboat maneuvering, IMO recommends an initial lowering and recovery without anyone on board to confirm proper functionality. Only after this check, we'll lower the lifeboat into the water, ensuring that only the necessary crew is on board to operate the boat effectively. All crew members should be familiarized with lifeboat equipment in the event of a real emergency. Therefore, during the abandoned ship drill, all crew will proceed inside the lifeboat for familiarization. Once all crew members have taken their seats, the safety officer and engineers will explain all relevant equipment and provide instructions. It covers topics such as food rations, drinking water, medicine, and pyrotechnics, including their locations and instructions for use. As a standard practice, all crew members should be familiar with lifeboat engine starting procedures. The lifeboat engine should be tested together with the rudder and operated both ahead and astern with alterations to the port and starboard sides. The engine should be started in accordance with the manufacturer's instructions, using either both batteries together or each battery separately. Additionally, we'll ensure that our searchlight, cabin light, position and compass lights are in good working order. If weather conditions permit, in addition to launching the lifeboat, maneuvering on water is also conducted. After successfully maneuvering, the lifeboat will be secured in its designated position. As per SOLAS requirements for the abandoned ship drill, we should pay attention to life raft launching devices. Not all vessels are equipped with davits for launching life rafts, however, A life raft serves as a secondary means of evacuation in case the lifeboats are not ready for launching or cannot be used in prevailing circumstances and conditions. The operation of davits and the life raft launching procedure should be a part of the drill, with detailed explanations about the launching procedures. During the abandoned ship drill, we'll also provide a brief explanation of the principles of action for radio life-saving appliances. These essential tools are designed to enhance our safety by facilitating search and rescue operations. Our abandoned ship drill is almost complete, with only the debriefing session with the crew remaining. Don't hesitate to ask questions during drills. Once, it can save your lives. Thanks for watching.